Hi everyone, I am the Game Gazelle. I'd say thank you for watching and thank you for tuning back in. So this is, let's see, this is Life is Strange. Is this the right one? Parking lot. Bingo, this is it. And we're gonna continue. Yeah, as I was saying, this is Life is Strange, the first one. Now, I know that the second one is out, and I just thought that if I go all the way back, I want to catch up the story with Max and how all things have gotten so strange with her life and everything that's been going on in between. And there's also another one called Before the Storm. I would like to play that one too. You know, just play all the games and see what the entire franchise is all about.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
So this is where we last left off. We left off here at the parking lot. Let's check.
I better go there soon to see if Joyce is still there, and get a burger.
Ah.
Good thing I don't have a car, yet.
Just going around, looking around. Look at this. Someone TP a car.
Who toilet papers a bike?
And there's that missing person poster again.
The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster.
Yeah. Pile of MPP.
Oh. Damn, somebody is seriously devoted to putting up these posters.
Yeah. Somebody graffitied that. Who's
that? I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that.
I don't get it. How could Zack and Victoria do that to me?
Miss Juliet.
Juliet still looks upset about Zack and Victoria. I don't blame her.
Let's talk to her.
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zack yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Yeah, that was wrong for her boyfriend to sex as a joke. That is not a joke. Oh, there's that pyramid again. Saw that in the bathroom. Check this out right here.
Now this really pisses me off. So entitled. Sorry, handicapped folks. My truck needs these two spots more than you do. Bastard. That layer of dust is begging for my finger.
Let's do it.
It's not a dirty window unless somebody writes clean me on it.
This action will have consequences.
I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay lots.
It's childish, but you know, let's keep it. Keep it as is. Oh, focal point it.
A new surveillance system. That's how it starts.
And we'll leave that up. Car theft warning. Over the past few months, there has been multiple break-ins of faculty and student vehicles in the Blackwell parking lot. A new surveillance system is being installed, but you should make sure your vehicle is always secure and locked. For more safety tips, contact David Madison. That tool. Yeah, we bumped into him last episode.
The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster.
Come on over here, please.
Will do. Hang tight.
Too bad those posters will be trashed and ignored.
Is that it? Okay, let's talk to Warren. He's eager to see Max. Man, Warren's close.
Max, get your ass over here.
Me too.
Look at Warren and his wayback machine. He's a brave man.
Let's talk to him.
And there's Warren. Did he actually buy a used car?
Yo, Max, check it out.
Okay.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks. Oh.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really?
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
Oh, somebody's jealous.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw.
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Alright.
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
About that one.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill.
Russ Mayer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But aww, you seem distracted.
Nah, let's talk.
I need to talk to somebody. Just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right?
Whoa.
You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now.
What is your problem?
Answer me, bitch!
Fine, I'll tell him the
truth. I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
And did what, give you a stern lecture?
Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Seriously. Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Oh!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal, or that whore in the bathroom!
Right, get him! Get him, Max!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Oh,
get it, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Crazy. He's straight up crazy.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Let's choose hopefully nothing.
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beatdown for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
Nah.
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah. Must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Yeah, let's just say I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Say something. She's mad, upset.
Broken. Man, are you serious?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Home sweet home. I guess.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Hey, where to now? Oh, birdie! So cute. Oh yeah, that's definitely Chloe's room.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
She's medicating all right.
Hard to believe Chloe was my BFF just 5 years ago.
So tell me. What does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Yeah,
I don't feel grown-up. Just more confused as I get older. Especially after today.
Gee, thanks. I was hoping to hear something positive.
About me?
No, about me. Duh. I thought you'd at least be happy taking photos. Forget it.
Yeah, let's go back. Oh, we can go faster.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do?
Taking photos?
I take photos. Of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely, not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless.
Perfect. What you got over here?
Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
A whole lot of beer and smokes.
Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
Dad's gone all.
Chloe's dad built this dresser.
See if we can go in.
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her.
In the closet.
Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair.
This.
This looks like a laundry bag.
What's in it? I'm nosy.
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Yeah. What's this up here?
Old cardboard boxes.
Oops!
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough.
Old cardboard boxes.
How do I get up there and get that? Okay, nice.
This postcard is from Rachel Ember.
Oh. Read this. Miss you, wish you were here, Rach.
Man, I remember this furniture. We spent all day painting it blue. We had such a blast
nice.
Drawing
this
together.
Look at those pictures. That's a Power Girls, Max, Chloe, and Super Kitty. Free Amigo Comic Snail, Black Hole Danger. With Chloe and Max, he's a killer. I really want to go up there and see how they get that. Is there a chair? Or something?
So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. We used to dare each other to climb down, but never did. Is this a desk or a storage space? I think this junk swallowed her desks.
There's a computer. What's on it?
Too bad I can't stream any music from Chloe's laptop. She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
Whoa. Yeah, she's stoned. In the garbage can.
Chloe's trash overfloweth. Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
Dang, that's a lot of parking tickets. Four? Anything around here? What's down there?
Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret.
What's there? Oh, there's Rachel. And her, giving up the finger.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
Yeah,
so
let's
she?
Not be super nosy.
Do you mind talking about her?
Rachel Ember. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
No, she never forgot.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
What about your mom? What did Joyce think about all this?
She couldn't wait to get rehitched. Step dick is one reason I wanted to bail.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
Well. What about her parents?
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Yeah, I'll do that. Alright, let's put on some tunes.
Hard to believe Chloe was my BFF just 5 years ago.
Can I talk to her?
Now can you please put on some jams?
Okay, doing it. Doing it.
It won't play without any power.
Okay. Okay, let's switch it on. Ah! And we got power. Let's do this. And load CD. My Chloe.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment. Snowdough. Thanks.
Damn. Chloe was kicked out of Blackwell 2 years ago. She used to be a great student. When she cared. 15 kids in the backyard
drinking wine. Hey. You tell me stories. Poster.
I'm not into them. Too pretentious.
It's TV.
Hey, that TV used to be in the living room.
Look around, see if I missed anything else.
Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret.
Okay, there's nothing down there, so I guess we got everything. It's going out. In here. I'm going. Can't go over there. Going down there. Oh, light switch. What's in here?
I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me.
Hey, what else is in here?
I wonder if Chloe is taking those pills. I hope she's okay.
Fluoxetine tablets. Pharmacist, please dispense with medication guide. Maybe her stepfather's taking them. Crazy as he is.
This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products.
There's Max. Anything else? That's about it.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am.
Oh, books.
These books have not been touched since the last decade. I see why. Nothing's changed. Except for me and Chloe.
I'm so nosy.
This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today.
Hey, Birdie.
You've been resurrected, Birdie. Fly, be free.
Yeah, be free.
Joyce always loved her mail order catalogs of useless crap. Aww. Joyce has a little shrine to William. Her new husband may not be such a douche. Uh-oh. The prices are late on their bills.
Wow, I'm looking at that price. $4,339.13. Woo, that's a lot of money. Hold it right here.
Joyce looks happy. Chloe's stepdad might not be a douchebag after all. Joyce still works at the diner, and Chloe's new dad is a security guard.
Oh boy. That's even more trouble. Oh, jury.
Oh my. Chloe made this for Joyce on Mother's Day years ago. I see why she would keep it. Act, React, or Die, a 21st Century Survival Guide. Whoa, apocalypse self-help.
Okay, nothing here, so let's go on downstairs. Go on down here. What just happened?
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days.
A lot of past due bills.
Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore.
Yeah. That was her when she was younger. Okay, oh, hold on a second. He changed this to the... Okay, and what do we got? Okay, hey, no problem. That's what friends are for. Got something from Victoria. What's he want? By the way, thanks, but we're not friends. Fair enough.
I love that they have the same old answering machine. And there's a message.
Chloe,
I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever.
Told me he saw you near that garbage dump. Now I've ordered... Told you to stay away from that place. It's dangerous. And you got no idea what kind of scum are living out there. Stay away. I'm serious.
Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking.
In the vase, not in the vase.
Joyce still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon.
Let's see. And a grocery list. Staticky, but it looks like it's talking about the weather. I'm turning off. What's around here? Nah, we don't need to turn the lights where it's on.
I'd love to go to Paris, too. At this rate, they'll be lucky to get to Portland. I guess they're aging these books. I should be able to find the tools I need here.